Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing mathematical tools and this is lecture 2. In first lecture we had started trigonometry and some basic concepts had been delivered. Right now we are going to extend some basic knowledge in trigonometry as well. And this lecture we are going to discuss some formulas which will be useful in physics. So today you apply some formula, basic formula of trigonometry, that is compound and multiple and submultiple angle and compound angle. So first I am going to write here compound angle right now. Compound angle means what? Combination of two angles. So there are some formulas which you must learn and must be aware to know this. For example, I'll verify also, but geometrical verification is not required. We will discuss it in mathematics class. And here, just for sake of knowledge, I can verify with some analytical examples. So the formula is sine A plus B. Some basic formula in trigonometry, surely you know that, but let me remind once again before writing these compound angles. So basic formula, let me write here. Some basic formula and thereafter we will write compound angle. Some basic formula of trigonometry is, there are three basic formulas, nothing else. One is sine square theta plus cos square theta. This is the basic one, right now. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is one. And contemporarily, this can be written as sine square theta is 1 minus cosec square theta. Sine square theta is 1 minus cos square theta. And cos square theta is 1 minus sine square theta. So it is not a specific, only one. This formula is very important. Now, second one is sec square theta minus tan square theta is 1. So we can write sec square theta is 1 plus tan square theta. And tan square theta is sec square theta minus 1. So it is not a specific. This formula is specific. And again, cosec square theta minus cot square theta is 1. So cosec square theta is 1 plus cot square theta is cosec square theta minus 1. So these are three basic one, and that you need to remember, not all of them, because all of them are derived from one another. So it is not that much important right now. So you will learn this. Right, these are some basic formula which you need to learn, and rest of them are application of these three. So you can do that. Now as I told you that we will discuss compound angle. So compound angle is what? Compound angle, right? Compound angle is sum of two angles. So there is a formula like sine A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. This is one formula. Similarly, there is sine A minus B. If there is A minus B, sine A minus B, then that sine will be here. These two sine will change. If sine A minus B, then it will be sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. Without wasting another space and time, I have just changed the sign. You will learn it, that sine A minus B, sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. Similarly, there is another formula which is in terms of cos. Cos A plus B is equal to nothing else but cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. Sine B. So this formula is also applicable. If there is a negative sign here, then that will be positive. For positive, there is negative sign. For negative, there is positive sign. So with this analogy, you can also memorize, right now. Similarly, there is another formula, say tan A plus B is equal to tan A plus tan B upon 1 minus tan A tan B, right now. This is the formula. So if there is a negative sign, then that will be also negative and this will be positive. So remember this formula, that is also applicable for tan. Similarly, there is another formula for cot can be also written, but not necessary to learn it. Cot A plus B is equal to cot A cot B minus 1 upon cot B minus cot A, cot B plus cot A, right? Na? And for negative value, there will be positive and that will be negative. So, you can memorize like this. These are some compound angles. Now, let me verify why this formula is true. Suppose someone has to calculate value of tan 15 degree or even tan 15 degree, or better to verify it for sine 120, sine 120 degree, right? No? Or even sine 120 degree, we can go ahead, sine 120 degree. Earlier we have calculated, but now using this formula and can write 90 degree plus 30 degree. Can I write like this? Using the formula, this is A instead of A and this is instead of B. So sine A plus B, like that is sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. So it will be written like sine A, that is sine 90 cos 30 plus cos 90 and sine 30. So, if you write this value, sine 90 is 1, cos 30 is nothing else but root 3 by 2, and cos 90 is 0, and sine 30 is 1 by 2. So, what is the value? Root 3. And sine 120 degree can be calculated by using this formula. So, this formula is verified. Here we have same, the value has been calculated earlier. Let me calculate once again that sine 120 degree can be written as sine 180 minus 60, that is sine 60, second quadrant sine 60 is positive, and value of sine 60 is root 3 by 2. So these two are same, right? Na? So it formula is verified already. In this way, I have verified, although there is a geometrical verification of these formulas, but not necessary to learn for physics. So that is why I am not giving you anything which is unnecessary and which is not useful in physics. Here I am going to discuss only those things which is useful in physics only. Now, we can calculate some other values as well by using this formula. For example, someone has to calculate tan 15 degree. Then he can write either tan 60 minus 45 or 30 minus 45, isn't it? Now, using the formula tan A minus B, we can write tan 60 minus tan 45 upon tan A minus tan B upon 1 plus tan A tan B, and you know tan 45 is 1, so this will be tan 60 is root 3, root 3 minus 1 plus 1 plus root 3, that is root 3 into 1. So root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1, this is the value of tan 15 degree. So you can memorize this. It is necessary to learn few values which will be useful. So tan 15 degree is nothing else but root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1, and that is also equal to cot 75 degree, right? Because you can write tan 15 is tan 90 minus 15, and tan 90 minus 15 is cot 90 minus 15, 90 minus 75, and that is cot 75. So we can write like this. If you rationalize this, remember there is another form also. Tan 15 is nothing else. Tan 15 degree is root 3 minus root 3 plus 1. If you multiply by root 3 minus 1 both the sides, numerator and denominator, that is called rationalization. Then this will be root 3 minus 1 whole square, which will be 3 plus 1 minus 2 root 3. And in denominator, this is a plus b, a minus b. And what is that? A square minus b square. So it will be 3 minus 1, that is 2. So 3 plus 1 is 4 minus 2 root 2. 4 minus 2 root 2 divided by 2. 4 minus, this is nothing else, 4 minus 2 root 2 and divided by 2, that is 2 minus root 2. So remember, this is what we gain now, that to remember this, right, you have to memorize this. The value is as the value is, let me write here, tan 15 is nothing else. You have concluded here, tan 15 degree is equal to cot 75 degree is equal to root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1, right? Root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1, or it can be also written as 2 minus root 3. So remember this will be useful. If this value will come, you will write this value. Similarly, tan 75 is root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 minus 1. Reciprocal of this will come, you can calculate. Tan 75 can be calculated. 1 minus tan 45 and tan 30 degree. Right now? So we can do this. This is tan 45 degree. Right now? So it will be 1 plus 1 by root 3 upon 1 minus 1 by root 3. So that is what will come. If you will take LCM, tan 75 will come like root 3 plus 1 upon root 3. That will be, if you rationalize in the previous way, it will be 2 plus root 3. I hope you got it. And that is equal to cot 15 degree. So you may calculate like this. So these are some values. Now, some multiple and submultiple angles are also there, which we need to learn. Multiple and submultiple angles. Right? So, multiple angle means if an angle is A, then multiple of A is 2A, 3A, 4A, or A by 2, like this. A by 2 is called submultiple. A, 2A, 3A are multiples. A by 2, A by 4, A by 5 are called submultiples, like this, if A be any angle. So here is a formula for sine. Sine 2A is equal to 2 sine A cos A. This is the formula which you need to learn. 2 sine A cos A, or you can learn it like 2 tan A upon 1 plus tan square A. 2 tan A plus 1 plus tan square A. This is right now. And similarly, cos 2A is what? Cos 2A is cos square A minus sin square A. Or we can write 1 minus 2 sin square A. 2 cos square A minus, changing sin into cos. Or there is another formula that can be written as 1 minus tan square A upon 1 plus tan square A. This is for sin 2A. And similarly, if there is tan 2A, we have tan 2A, then the formula tan square A. Now, if I am looking for submultiple, then what will happen? If I am writing for submultiple, then let me draw this line and write here again. Right? So submultiple angle, right? So let me write here few formulas are related to submultiple. So sine 2A is this, right? So can I write like sine A is equal to, what is sine A? Sine A, if this formula is made for 2A, remember this is 2A, then that angles are A and A, right? So if I'll write it for sine A, then what will the formula? This will be 2 sine A by 2 cos A by 2. Can I write like this? Yes, we can write like this. Similarly, here we can write 2 tan A by 2 upon 1 plus tan square A by 2. So this is also a formula, and you can go with this concept for any multiple or submultiple, right now? Any multiple or submultiple. This is A by 2, this is A by 2, you know, this is A by 2, this is A by 2. So if this angle is A, then that will be A by 2. If this angle is A by 2, that will be A by 4. If this angle is 4A, then that will be 2A, 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 half of the angle. Similarly, here formula for sine 2A is given. If it is 4a sine 4a, then it will be 2 sine 2a cos 2a, like that, half of the angle. So remember this concept, and you can utilize this concept anywhere. Here the formula for cos is given, and you may calculate it for other one also. For example, here cos 2a is what? 1 minus 2 sine square a. So 1 minus 2 sine square a, if 2 sine square a can come this side and cos 2a come this side, then it will be positive. So remember, this is useful, and that is why I am writing here. You can write here cos a is equal to 1 minus cos 2a is equal to 2 cos sine square a. 1 minus cos 2a is equal to 2 sine square a. Remember this, right? Sine square a. 1 plus cos 2a, similarly, this one will come this side, it will be positive, isn't it? And 1 plus cos 2a will be, what is left this side? 2 cos square a. For submultiple, if there is like 1 plus cos a, then we can write it 2 cos square a by 2. Because this is 2a here, then that is a, you know. If it is a, then that must be a by 2, isn't it? A, then it must be a by 2. So hopefully you are getting this point, that this formula is not applicable for only one of them, but it is applicable for all type of multiple and submultiple. Similarly, if someone has given 1 minus cos a, then what we can write? 2 sine square a by 2 minus then sine square a, this formula. So you can utilize like this. I hope you got it. 2 tan a is 2 tan a upon 1 minus tan square a. Similarly, if there is a formula that tan a, then we can write it 2 tan a by 2 upon 1 minus tan square a by 6. What multiple and submultiple. Also, there is some formula for 3a. If there is a formula for 2a, then there must be formula for 3a. So sine 3a is equal to, formula is 3 sine a minus 4 sine qa, and cos 3a is formula like 4 cos qa p cos a. Tan 3a, the formula is 3 tan a minus tan qa upon 1 minus 3 tan square a. So these are few more formulas which you should learn it, like sine, say sine 37 degrees 3 by 5. It is approximate value, but it will be useful in trigonometry, right? Now sine 37 is nothing else but cos 53 as well. This is cos 53. So cos 53 is also sine is 3 by 5. Right now, sine, again you write sine 53 degree is equal to 4 by 5. So that is cos 37 degree is equal to 4 by 5. Isn't it? Because sine 53 is equal to cos 47. So you will use it directly wherever it is required. Right now, so it is because of a triangle where 3, 4 and 5. And these are some values, so we will consider it like, say if this is a triangle and theta is 37 degree, right, theta is 37 degree, then in this case this one is 90 and this is A, this one is B and this one is C. So if this is 37 degree, then that must be 53 degree, and this one is 90. So if for 37, see this is 3, this one is 4, this one is 5. So similarly, you can utilize here also for tan, and tan 37 is equal to what? Then set 4, and that is got also 53. Tan 37 is cot 53, and tan 53 perpendicular upon base, so that is 4 by 3. So remember, these are some values which will be useful And if you remember this, there will be quick calculation. It will be helpful in calculation, so you can memorize it. Similarly, some other values to be also taken into consideration, like sine 60, sine 75, sine 15, cos 15. This should be also known, and you should know that sine 15. If you want to calculate sine 15, then how to calculate? So you will write sine 60 minus 45, isn't it? That will be sine 60 cos 45 minus cos 60. That will be root 3 minus 1 upon 2 root 2. So again, you can add sine 15 cos 75 degree is equal to root 3 minus 1 upon 2 root 2. So this is one value which you can keep in mind. And sometimes if you have to calculate sine 75 degree, then what is that? Or even cos 15 degree, then also it will be sine 75 degree. So cos 15 degree or sine 75 degree, in similar way we can calculate, right now. So sine, right, 45 plus 30, sine 45 plus 30, that will be 75, and it will be 1 by 2. So that will be root 3 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. So there will be some values like that you can write here. And root 3 minus 1 upon 2 root 2, root 3 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. So here again you can write here sine 75 degree is equal to cos 15 degree is equal to same root 3 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. That can be calculated. Some more values are useful which will be remember, say tan 22 and half degree, right? How to calculate? Theta is equal to, say A is 22 and half degree, so tan 2A must be equal to what, 45 degree. If I'll apply the formula, what we have learned, that tan 2A is equal to tan 45 degree, isn't it? So that will be, again further formula, if I use it, 2 tan A minus tan square A is equal to tan 45 is 1. So this will come like 2 tan A is equal to 1 minus tan square A. And this will come like tan square A plus 2 tan A is equal to 1. If I add 1 is equal to 2. So this formula will come like tan square 2A plus 2 tan A plus 1 will be nothing else but tan A plus 1 whole is equal to 2. So we can write tan A plus 1 is equal to root 2. Isn't it? Tan A plus 1 is root 2. So tan A is equal to root 2 minus 1. Tan A is equal to, and tan A is equal to root 2 minus 1. So what is A? Tan 22 and half degree. So therefore tan 22 and half degree, that is pi by 8, is equal to root 2 minus 1. That is also equal to cot 67 and half degree. So you can remember these few values as well, and wherever it will be useful, you will use it. So I hope what you learn. Thereafter, graphs of this trigonometric function as well, but when we will discuss it, that how to plot the graph of sine x, cos x, tan x, etc. Because it will be also useful while we will discuss the scapular motion. So this while we will discuss it, the hopefully you got all these points and you have learned what I wanted to tell you in basic trigonometry, except the graph. And we will discuss the graph when we will discuss the graph of different type of functions. Then we will discuss it. Till then, bye bye. God bless. Keep watching. Right.